Hello students, this is Neha Mathur and today in this video I will let you know about JK flip-flops, which is the next topic or next type of flip-flops. But before starting the video, consider to subscribe my channel and click on bell icon to get updated for the upcoming videos. So our today's topic is JK flip-flop. See, JK flip-flop is basically designed so that all the issues coming from SR flip-flop can be overcome. There was main one issue which is related to SR flip-flop is when SR flip-flop is operated for S is equals to 1 as well as R is equals to 1, the circuit shows uncertainty, or we can say that circuit behaves under prohibited condition. So for S and R is equals to 1, or for the input S is equals to R is equals to 1, the circuit is not applicable. This is the reason that SR flip-flop is not able to deal with this input. So to overcome this issue or to overcome the uncertainty problem, for this case JK flip-flop is introduced. So JK flip-flop is the next classification of flip-flops. So we will discuss about JK flip-flop, that how by using JK flip-flop we can remove this issue. Fine. So we will start with the circuit diagram of the JK flip-flop, then with the help of truth table we will resolve all the cases one by one. So the next is its circuit diagram. Again, this circuit diagram consists four NAND gates. The same circuit can also be implemented with the help of NOR gate. Or I can say that any universal gate, NAND or NOR, can be used for the implementation of any flip-flop. I am using NAND gate for its implementation, and like SR flip-flop, here we will again use four gates with name G1. I am denoting the name from back side, G2, G3 and G4, gate 1, gate 2, gate 3 and gate 4. Since this is a JK flip-flop, so its main input is J and the second input is K. The second thing is, I am using a single clock to initiate the circuit. Now the same circuit will again follow the concept of cross coupling structure, which means the output of gate G1 is connected with the input of G2. Similarly, the output of gate G2 is connected with the input of G1. So the back structure itself showing the cross coupling structure. Now this is the circuit diagram. If I am removing these two inputs, then this is the circuit diagram for SR flip-flop. Now how this circuit diagram is converted for JK flip-flop, for this what you will have to do here, you will have to use feedback connections. So you can say SR flip-flop with feedback connection represents the circuit diagram of JK flip-flop. Now what is the feedback connection? The actual meaning of the feedback connection is the output of the main circuit, which is your Q and Q bar, is connected at its main input. So I am mentioning the feedback connections, which mean the main output, which is Q, is connected with its main input from G4. So you can mention it like this: the output is connected at its input. You may also use the indication like this, from here to there, but it will become more complex. That's why I am mentioning look like this, that the output is just connected at its main input. So now I have G4 gate with its three inputs. The first input is K, the second input is representing for clock, and the third input, which is coming from its feedback connection from Q. Similarly, your second output is Q bar. It will again work as a feedback connection with its main input. So your Q will again be connected with your main input. So now for the G3 NAND gate, you will have again three inputs: J, clock and Q bar. So this is the main circuit diagram for your JK flip-flop, and I am again repeating, when your SR flip-flop circuit diagram is implemented with using main feedback connection, it becomes JK flip-flop. So this is the circuit diagram for JK flip-flop, which is basically used to remove uncertainty problem which is coming from SR flip-flop circuit diagram. Now come with its truth table, or I can say that it's working, how it will work. So once I will discuss the four cases, because here you have main two inputs J and K. So for two inputs you will have 00 01 10 and 11, four possible combination of binary inputs. So we will discuss one by one each and individual combination of these inputs, that how your circuit will respond with single combination of inputs. Then by concluding these individual cases, we will draw a truth table. So now we will discuss its working. See, just remember that your circuit will work when your clock is equals to 1. So when clock is equals to 1, we will deal with each cases. Now your first case is when J is equals to 0 and K is also 0. The second case is when J is equals to 0 and K is equals to 1. What about case third? The case third is when J is equals to 1 and your K is equals to 0. Case fourth is when J is equals to K is equals to 1. And the main issue, or I can say the main advantage of this circuit to overcome the issue for this circuit, for this combination. So this is the most important combination. Now see how it will overcome the issue coming from SR flip-flop, but we will start one by one. So your first combination is when J is equals to K is equals to 0. That means your both the inputs having value 0. Now see G3, which is a NAND gate, and the functionality of the NAND gate is multi product of the variable with complement will provide your, it will provide the output of the NAND gate. So G3, since one of its input is 0, then and clock is 1, then no need to go with third input, which is your Q bar, because whatever it will be, when it this value is multiplied by 0, it will be 0 and its complement will be 1. So the output of the G3 will be 1. G3 output will be 1. Similarly, since K is also 0, the same concept will apply for G4 gate, and again the output of G4 will be 0. Sorry, 1. Why? Because its one input is 0. When 0 is multiplied by any of its input, it will be 0, and the complement of the 0 will be 1. So for G3 and G4, in both the cases, the output is 1. Now the output of G3 is directly connected with G1. Similarly, the output of G4 is directly connected with G2. Now come with the execution of the operation of your gate G1. What will be the output of your gate G1? See, G1 gate has its two inputs. The one input is 1, but we are not familiar with its second input. Similarly, when we will discuss about G2, again G2 is presenting over here with one input, which is 1, but we are again not confident with its second input. So there is no possibility to calculate Q and Q bar with these data. So we need to assume Q and Q bar, and initially I am assuming Q is equals to 1, so your Q bar will be 0. Now when Q is equals to 1, here it will be 1. Now both the inputs for your G2 is 1 and 1. So 1.1 it will be 1 and its complement will be 0. That means your Q bar will be 0. Q bar is itself 0. Now this 0 is coming here for your G1 gate. Now one input is 1 and the second input is 0. So 1 into 0 0 and its complement will be 1. So your Q will be 1. That means if you are assuming Q is equals to 1 and Q bar is equals to 0, the circuit will remain in its own state and it will store Q is equals to 1 and Q bar is equals to 0. Similarly, if you are initially you are assuming Q is equals to 0 and Q bar is equals to 1, then see your Q is equals to 0. Now for G2, two inputs is 0 and 1. So 0 is multiplied by 1, it will be 0 and its complement will be 1. So your Q bar will be 1. Similarly, when this one is directly applied for the input of your G1, then 1.1 it will be 1 and its complement will be 0. So your Q will be 0. I am again repeating, the direct calculation of Q and Q bar, or you cannot find your output over here without help of previous values. This is the reason your this state of JK flip flop is again said to be previous state dependency, because the calculation of your outputs depends on previous state. Without assuming the values of your previous state Q and Q bar, you cannot find what will be the actual bit which is stored by this circuit. So if you are assuming your Q is equals to 1, then circuit will store in its own memory cell 1, while if you are assuming your Q is equals to 0, it will store 0 as a memory storage bit. So depends on its previous value. So same like SR flip flop, the case first is said to be previous state, because the calculation is depends on previous values. So the state is said to be previous state. Now come with next case. The next case, when J is equals to 0 and K is equals to 1. Initially, I am erasing all the values so that it will be easy to understand. Then we will apply J is equals to 0 and K is equals to 1. Okay. Now see, your J is equals to 0 and your K is equals to 1. That means, if we are talking about inputs of G3, then for the G3, one input is 0. Second input, which is clock, is initially set at 1. And your third input is Q bar, which is not defined. So whatever the value of Q bar, whenever it will be multiplied by 0, it will be 0. And its complement will be 1. So the output of the G3 will be 1. G3 output is 1. Your second case, when J is equals to 0 and K is equals to 1. See, for J is equals to 0 and K is equals to 1, this circuit is set for reset state, in which your Q will be 0 and Q bar will be 1. And for this combination of output is itself represent in reset state. So second case is for reset state, like SR flip-flop. The complete execution of these steps of the circuit is like SR flip-flop. Now come with third case, in which J is equals to 1 and K is equals to 0. See, for this case the circuit is defining itself in set state, like SR flip-flop. I am again repeating, here again the execution of the steps for this combination of input is like SR flip-flop, for which your Q will be 1 or Q bar will be 0. So now Q will be 1 and Q bar will be 0, and this combination of output shows this case in set state. So this is your set state when J is equals to 1 and K is equals to 0, like SR flip-flop. Now come with The fourth case, which is most important case of this circuit, which is supposed to design to overcome the issue of uncertainty, which is coming from SR flip-flop. So, your JK flip-flop, see, when J is equals to 1 and K is also 1. Now, come with the execution of G3 gate. For your G3 gate, one input is 1. Second input is clock, which is again 1. Now come with third input, which is not defined. So again we will have to assume initially the value of output. And initially I am assuming Q is equals to 1. Here you will have to again assume. So your Q is equals to 1 and Q bar is equals to 0. So as per the concept of the flip-flops, if which we are revising till now, what happens if initially you are assuming 1 at one input and 0 at second input, then after the execution of the complete step, the circuit will remain in its own state. That means if you are assuming Q is equals to 1, then the execution of its operation, it will remain in this state by maintaining Q is equals to 1 and Q bar is equals to 0. Similarly, if initially you are assuming Q is equals to 0, just opposite, and Q bar is equals to 1, then after the execution of the operation, it will maintain in its own state by maintaining Q is equals to 0 and Q bar is equals to 1. So now see what will happen with this combination. Here your Q is equals to 1. So this one is coming as an input for G4. Similarly, Q bar is equals to 0, which is the input for G3. Now come with the input for G3. For the G3, your one input is 1, second input is again 1, and the third input is 0. So it will be 0, complement of 0, it will be 1. So now the one input of G3 is 1 and the second input is, we are considering from initially, which is 0. That means 1.0 zeros bar and it will be 1. It is 1. So come with the lower side gate for G4. The one input is 1. The second input is clock, which is again 1. And your third input is 1. So 1's complement, it will be 0. Now for your G2 gate, lower side gate, one input is 0. No need to go with second input, but if you want, you can assume your second input is 1 and the first input is 0. So it will be 1. Now it will be 1. Now the twist with this circuit is, initially we were assuming our Q bar as 0, but now it becomes 1. Now this one, which is working as an input for your G1 gate, it will become 1, and 1.1 with its complement will be 0. So now your Q become 0, which initially we were assuming 1. Again, if you will go with next time execution by assuming your Q is equals to 0 and Q bar is equals to 1, Q is equals to 0 and Q bar is equals to 1, after the execution of the complete cycle, this 1 will be 1, 0 will be 1 and this 1 will be 0. So this is the twist. See, in SR flip-flop, when you were assuming your S and R is equals to 0, the circuit was showing uncertainty condition. What was that? According to that, in that case, you were getting your Q and Q bar both is equals to 0, which is practically not possible because Q and Q bar should be complementary to each other. Here, you are getting Q and Q bar in its complementary form. If your Q is equals to 1, then Q bar is equals to 0. Similarly, if Q is equals to 0, your Q bar is equals to 1. And if your Q is equals to 1, again your Q bar is equals to 0. So, for this case, you are getting Q and Q bar in complementary form. It is not showing uncertainty condition, but the twist is, if initially you are assuming Q is equals to 1 and Q bar is equals to 0, then as per the concept of memory cell, it should hold its initial assuming values, but this case is not showing the initial assuming values. This is the trick with this case. This is the reason that this case comes under toggle state. Toggle, I am again repeating the word T-O-G-G-L-E. That means your fourth case is for toggle state. What does it mean? Initially, if you are assuming your Q is equals to 1 and Q bar is equals to 0, after the execution, as per the general principle of flip-flop, it should maintain its own assuming state. That means if you are assuming 1-0, it should show 1 and 0, but it is showing 0-1. Similarly, if you are assuming 0-1, it should show 0-1, but it is showing 1-0. So that means toggle 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. This is the reason your fourth case, which is removing the uncertainty problem, but the new term is introducing over here, which is toggle state. And this problem with JK flip-flop is said to be race around condition. In general, most of the exams, the question is asked, what do you mean by race around condition? So race around condition is a problem which is coming from JK flip-flop when J and K both are operated at its binary value, which is 1. So this fourth case with toggle state is said to be race around condition. Now by concluding these four cases, we will simply make a truth table for all the cases. Truth table between inputs. Here you have J and K two inputs. See, I am mentioning here that your clock is 1. The complete execution, all the cases are executing over here when your clock is equals to 1. So what about outputs? You have two outputs, Q and Q bar. Now come with all the cases. And here I will mention the state. What will be the state? For your first case, when Q, J and K is equals to 0, then the output, if you are assuming 0, it will be 0. If you are assuming 1, it will be 1. Similarly, likewise, if it is 0, it will be 1, and if it is 1, it will be 0. So it depends on previous state, or you can say it depends on your assumption. Initially, whatever the state of your flip-flop, it will maintain the state for the inputs J is equals to 0 and K is equals to 0. Now come with second case. When J is equals to 0 and K is equals to 1, your circuit will be in reset state by providing Q is equals to 0 and Q bar is equals to 1, like JK flip-flop. Like SR flip-flop. So no need to go with in depth here for this case. Similarly, for third case, when J is equals to 1 and K is equals to 0, it will be in set state by providing Q is equals to 1 and Q bar is equals to 0. Now come with your fourth case, in which J is equals to 1 and K is also 1. For this condition, the first thing is, there is no possibility to calculate Q and Q bar directly. So we will go with the assumption of the Q and Q bar. So if initially you are assuming Q, then it will become 1. And if you are assuming initially 1, then it will be 0. Similarly, by following this values of your Q, if initially you are assuming Q as a 0, then your Q bar will be 1. So when it is toggling from 0 to 1, it will be 1 to 0. Similarly, for your second assumption, if Q is equals to 1 and it is converting into 0, your Q bar will be 0 and it will convert into 1. So this state is said to be toggle state. Toggling, switching 1 to 0, 0 to 1. There is no possibility to predict the output, what will be the output. And this fourth case, which is removing or overcoming the issue of uncertainty of JK flip-flop, is introducing the next problem, which is your race around condition, or you can say race around problem in toggle state. So this is the concept of JK flip-flop. Now the thing is, like JK flip-flop, which is used to overcome the problem of SR flip-flop, similarly here we have one more modified flip-flop, which is your master slave flip-flop. Master slave flip-flop is used to overcome race around condition coming from JK flip-flop. So in next video I will tell you about master slave flip-flop, which is used to overcome problem coming from JK flip-flop, that is your race around condition. And if you are following the concept, consider to subscribe my channel and click on bell icon to get updated for the upcoming videos. Thank you.